Like many things, you know, that you start with, you see the sphere expand in front of you of where you can go with it. And I started to feel a lot more of a personal connection then with marine conservation, which before that had been a little bit of an abstract concept, especially growing up in Canberra. You know, we used to go down to the coast fairly often, but I didn't have day-to-day experience with the ocean.
And we'll just have a walk around and see what we find, and maybe sort of around the sides of the forest.
I teach about things that I feel passionate about, and it's also the sorts of things that students can easily get excited about and passionate about, because they're real world situations and animals and living systems that they can see and touch and understand. What I really enjoy seeing is the growing confidence that students have over a period of a few days to make a statement or ask a question from a position of understanding rather than kind of feeling in the dark, oh, is this what Richard wants to hear? And then going out, whether it's measuring sea turtle nests or counting fish or measuring photosynthesis in coral or whatever it might be, that they understand the biology of what's going on, but then they also start to understand how to ask questions. When you do biology and you work with animals, you've got to work to their timetable. And so if that means you work at night, or you means you work long hours, or it means you work in uncomfortable conditions and environments, well, that's what you've got to do. I've always found that just the experience of doing that is partly, you know, its own reward. You want to get the answers to the questions you're asking at the same time, but it's part of the great experience, and I love that.
These are hatchlings that we incubated from eggs that we collected from Heron Island, and they've been growing with, it's part of a climate change effect on sea turtle study that we're doing. And so we'll actually be sending them back up to Queensland in a couple of days to be released.
I started working with sharks 7 or 8 years ago, and initially my interest was just to understand a little more about the stress that sharks experience when they get caught. It's about 100 million sharks a year caught and killed by fisheries. Now, some of those, or a large proportion of those, are for the shark fin trade, but there's an additional unknown quantity that are bycatch. And it's that group of animals in particular that's a big question mark when we want to understand what a sustainable practice is, and that's what I'm trying to address. Sometimes it takes quite a long time before you can take knowledge and translate that into management. But now, recently working with the Fisheries Management Authority, we're talking more specifically about, okay, how can handling practices change, for instance, and how could the type and duration of fishing gear change to minimise the impact on sharks? I have quite a strong personal commitment to conservation and effective management. And I try as much as possible within the research that I do to work in that direction. And then with the teaching to inspire students to think in a similar way.